Hi all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And before we continue, make sure to subscribe, hit that like button and turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. Today we're doing parts of plant and their functions. Plants are extremely important to life on earth. Plants provide food, medicine, shelter and the oxygen we need to breathe. In fact, everything we eat comes directly or indirectly from plants. Herbivores and omnivores depend on plants for survival. Even carnivores depend on plants because they often prey on animals that eat plants. Plants also provide shelter and habitats for many animals. Plants also help to slow erosion because their roots hold soil in place. When plants carry out photosynthesis, they take in carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and release oxygen for us to breathe. Now let us see a summary of what we're going to see in today's video. Roots anchor the plant in the soil and absorb nutrition and water that are needed by the rest of the plant. Stem support the upper part of the plant and act as a transport system for nutrition, water, sugar and starches. Leaves are the part of the plant where photosynthesis usually occurs, where food for the plant is made. Flowers are the reproductive parts of plants. They often have showy petals and fragrance to attract pollinators. After flowers are pollinated and fertilized, they produce seeds in the ovary of the plant. Fruits are the fleshy substance that usually surrounds seeds. They protect the seed. Seeds contain plant material that can develop into another plant. This plant material is called embryo. Plants have two distinct systems, a root system and a shoot system. The shoot system contains of stems, leaves and the reproductive parts of plant, flowers and fruits. The shoot system generally grows above the ground, where it absorbs the light needed for photosynthesis. The root system, which supports the plant and absorbs water and minerals, is usually underground. Now we are going to see root system. The part of the plant that grows under the soil is called root. This part of the plant is mainly responsible for anchoring it down into the ground and absorbing essential mineral elements, nutrition and water from the soil. It also used to store food. Now functions of root. Anchoring. Roots are the reason plants remain attached to the ground. They support the plant body, ensuring that it stands erect. Absorption. Primary function of roots is to absorb water and dissolve minerals from the soil. This is crucial as it helps in the process of photosynthesis. Storage. Plants prepare food and store in the form of starch in leaves, shoots and roots. Prominent examples include carrot, radish, beetroot, turnip, yam, etc. Root systems are mainly of two types, taproot, with a taproot that is larger and grows faster than the branch roots, fibrous roots, with all roots about the same size. Taproot. Taproot systems have a main root that grows down vertically and from which many smaller lateral roots arise. Taproots penetrate deep into the soil and are advantageous for plants growing in dry soil. Example, mustard, carrot, beetroot, parsley, China rose, balsam, hibiscus, bean and mustard plant. Fibrous root systems are located closer to the surface and have a dense network of roots. Fibrous root systems can help prevent soil erosion. Example, grass, rice, onion, wheat, maize, marigold, banana and corn. Now, the shoot system. The part of the plant that grows above the soil is called shoot. It has stem, branches, leaves, fruit, bud, and flowers. Stem. The main part of the shoot is stem. Functions of stem. Transportation. The main function of stem is to conduct water, and minerals absorbed by the root to all parts of the plant. In leaves, these water and minerals are converted into a usable product called starch by the process of photosynthesis. The stem transports prepared starch from the leaf to other parts of the plant. Stem supports leaves, flowers, and fruit. The stem allows the leaves to arrange in a way that they are able to receive direct sunlight in order to efficiently perform photosynthesis. The arrangement and position of leaves also allow for gases exchange. The stems bear fruits and flowers in a position that facilitates the process of pollination and fertilization. Now, storage. Some stems undergo modification to store food and water. Example, sugarcane, ginger, potato, and turmeric. Few green stems contain chloroplasts and are capable of carrying out photosynthesis as well. Some stems are soft and some are hard. Trees such as banyan and mango have hard and strong stems. It is called trunk. Plants producing woody stems are called trees and shrubs. Some plants like the banana have a thick, soft green stem. The stems of some plants like the money plant and ivy plant are weak. These weak stems cannot hold the plant up straight. Such plants need a support to climb up. They are known as climbers. Example, bean, cucumber, and money plant. Creeper. Creeper is considered to be the plant that grows along the ground by means of extending stem or branches and produce fiber-like roots that arise from the base of the stem. Example, pumpkin. Now we're going to see leaf. A leaf is green, flat, lateral outgrowth in plants. They come in different shapes, sizes, and colors and are generally flattened and thin. The flat part of a leaf is called leaf blade. The lower side is rough and lighter in color. The upper side is smooth and darker in color. In the middle of the leaf blade is a thin tube running from the stem to the tip of the leaf. This is called main vein. There are many smaller tubes running from the main vein. These are called side veins. Water is carried to the leaf through these veins. The lower side of a leaf has many tiny holes. Plants breathe through these tiny holes. These holes are called stomata. Air enters the leaf through the stomata. Functions of leaf. A leaf is called the kitchen of the plant. This is because they are the main organ responsible for photosynthesis, through which the plant produces its energy, its food. They obtain their green color due to the presence of chlorophyll. Photosynthesis. This is the most important function of a leaf. As we know, plants are living things and they need food and water to survive. Leaves prepare food for the whole plant. They use water, air, sunlight in the presence of a green substance called chlorophyll present in them. This chlorophyll catches the sunlight to make food. Leaves get water from the roots through the stem. They take carbon dioxide from the air with the help of the carbon dioxide, water, and sunlight. It prepares food for the plant. This process of making food is called photosynthesis. So leaves are called the kitchen or food factory of the plant. During photosynthesis, leaves give out a gas called oxygen, which is breathed in by all living things. The food goes to all parts of the plant through the stem. A part of the food made by the leaves is used up by the plant to grow. The remaining part of the food is stored in its seeds, stems, roots, fruits, or leaves. Plants do not make food at night. Plants breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide during the night. Leaves help the plant to breathe. Stomatas are responsible for regulating water in and out of the cell. It is also responsible for exchange of gases. Storage of food. In some plants, the leaves are modified to store food. Example, lettuce, spinach, cabbage, onion, garlic, etc. Transpiration. refers to the movement of water through the plant and subsequent evaporation via the leaves. When the stomata open to accommodate the diffusion of carbon dioxide into the plant for photosynthesis, water flows out. This process also serves to cool the plant through evaporation of the water from the leaf. Now, flower. The most beautiful part of a plant is the flower. We see flowers like rose, jasmine, and lotus. Flowers are of many colors, shapes, and sizes. Most of the flowers look very beautiful. Many flowers have a pleasant fragrance too. A flower blooms from a bud. Functions of flower. The main functions of flower is to produce seed. The flower grows into fruit. The flower helps the plant to reproduce. Now, fruit. The flowers of different plants grow into fruits. We all like to eat fruits because mostly they are fleshy, tasty, and juicy. Many fruits are delicious to eat. Most of the fruits contain seeds inside them. Some fruits have only one seed. Others have a number of seeds. Some fruits have no seeds. Some fruits like the papaya and watermelon, pomegranate, contain many seeds inside them. Some fruits like the orange, apple, etc. contain a few seeds in them. Some fruits like the mango, peach, lychee, etc. contain only one seed in them. Some fruits like the banana have no seeds. Functions of fruits. A fruit protects the seed within it. From these seeds, new plants grow. Now, seeds. Most plants grow from their seeds. Each seed contains a baby plant inside them. It is protected by the outer part of the seed, which also stores food for the baby plant. The baby plant grows when the seed gets air, water, and sunlight. It keeps growing till it becomes an adult plant. Functions of seeds. Every seed has a baby plant within it, which grows into a new plant. Fruits and seeds are formed from flowers by the process of pollination and fertilization. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe, hit that like button, and turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see you all next time. Goodbye!